So we're going to go over a blocked PAC. And what this means is when we say block, we're meaning AV block. So this occurs when you have a PAC, so you have an early atrial contraction, which we know a PAC is an early atrial contraction, and that typically will get captured by the AV node and sent to the ventricles for ventricular depolarization, which is our QRS. However, we do know that when cells depolarize, they are refractory for some time. The AV node also has a refractory period. And so a blocked PAC will occur when this PAC happens when the AV node is refractory. And if the AV node is refractory, when that PAC occurs, we won't see the beat be conducted. So what that might look like, right, is you've got your normal sinus P wave, you've got your QRS, this is a normal beat, and then you've got your T wave, and then you have a PAC. That's our PAC. But our AV node is blocked, and so you're not going to see a QRS occur. And then you're going to see a little pause, and then you're going to have that P wave again, and then you'll have your normal QRS T. So that's a blocked PAC. And that occurs because at this point in time, our AV node is still refractory, or it is still repolarizing, right? And so the AV node is just, it's a very interesting group of cells in the body where they can, they experience something called decremental conduction. So it has decremental conduction. And what that means is that the faster the rate, so if the sinus node beats faster, the worse the AV node performs. So that means that that PR interval might increase just a little bit. So that's something I just want to just bring up too. We'll look at it in this next EKG. So remember, blocked PAC is an atrial contraction that is not conducted. There is no QRS. Right, and also just remember this other idea that we can experience decremental conduction within the AV node. Let's take a look at an EKG. So here we've got an EKG. Let's just take a quick glance through what you're going to notice. We'll look at, say, V1. This is a rhythm strip kind of all the way through. So we see we've got QRS, QRS, QRS. I expect a QRS here, but I don't see one. QRS, I expect one here. I don't see one. QRS, then we'd see QRS is marching along, right? If we look at the QRSs closely, we see we've got our P wave causing QRS, and then the T wave. We've got kind of a quick P wave, and if you look, this P wave morphology is just upright. The normal P waves that you'll see here, it's a little up and down, so the morphology is a little different. I actually think this is a PAC. If you notice, what's really interesting about this PAC is the PR interval, which is our AV node, is a little longer than the previous interval. So this is an example of decremental conduction by our AV node because it's just a quick B, right? It's a rapid rate, but it's still conducted. And then we see here we've got our normal P to our QRS, and then we have a PAC, bam, PAC, that happens quick. It's a pretty rapid sequence there, and if you've noticed, there's no QRS. And then we have the resumption of RP to QRS. Then we have another P wave that's pretty early. There's no QRS. So both of these beats are blocked PACs, meaning that the premature atrial contraction occurred when the AV node was refractory. And then we notice that when there's no PACs that occur, we have our normal Ps, QRS, normal P, QRS, normal P, QRS, normal P, QRS, normal P, QRS. When there's no PACs, our AV node has enough time to completely repolarize and capture that next beat. So not all PACs are blocked, but in some, depending on the person's health of their AV node, if it takes them longer to repolarize, then you might have these refractory moments. And if you have a PAC, just when that AV node is still refractory, it's going to become blocked. It's going to become blocked. So hope this helps. And when you see a pause, take a look and see, was it a PAC? Was it blocked? Or is this a different type of AV block, right? So the reason why I know that these are blocked PACs is because the morphology of the P wave, the morphology suggests ectopic P waves. And if I measure the interval from P to P compared to the normal interval P to P, it's shorter. So they're premature. So these are premature beats that are occurring early. These are very early P to P intervals. So hope this helps. Have a good day.